morning students. We really welcome you to the new classes that we are going to start in class 12th. Although we cannot meet, but we have to utilize this time. So we are starting on with class 12 chemistry first book. That's chapter number 2, solutions. And basically there are first three chapters are numerical based chapters. They'll comprise the physical chemistry part. Then the second part, which is very important, is the organic chemistry part. And in that organic chemistry part, we'll do in book number 2. So first we'll start with numerical base, then we'll move on to organic chemistry. And then in the last, we'll move on to inorganic chemistry. So like that, we'll divide the chapters. There are 15 chapters net total in class 12. So we'll first start with solution chapters. Just a brief recap of what we have already done in class 11th. We already, you know, a little about mixtures. When we say mixtures, we say it is a mixture of two, three or more things together. So whenever we talk of solutions, basically it's a type of mixture. Now when we talk of mixture, the mixture can be of two types. It can be either a mixture which has two, three components uniformly mixed. If we say it is uniformly mixed, we say it is a type of homogeneous mixture. Like, if I take sugar and I dissolve it in water, that means the sugar gets uniformly dissolved in the water. So it makes a homogeneous mixture. Then if you talk of the other type, the mixtures in which it is not uniformly distributed, like alloys we have. Alloys is a mixture of metals, but the metals are not of uniform composition. So we call it heterogeneous mixture. So we talk of homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. In solution, we'll mainly focus in this, the main state or the main part would be in liquid form. So we'll concentrate on those solutions which have main component as liquids. But basically, there are, in a binary solution, there are two components. One is in larger quantity, the other is in lesser quantity. So when we say larger quantity, so I've written there are two, the components are basically two. So we'll write here solute and solvent. The one which is in larger quantity, we say it is the solute. The one which is in lesser quantity is the solvent, right? So if I say I'm taking a glass of sugar and I'm dissolving 1 spoon of sugar into a glass of water, the solute would be the sugar and the solvent would be the water. So they are basically two components of a solution. Then we'll move on to the types of solution. I've already written the types. There are mainly three types of solution. You can just see it is the solute, it is the solvent, it is the example. So if I say gas is dissolved in gas, we say it is a type of gaseous solutions. Gas in gas, liquid in gas, solid in gas. We come to the second type, that is liquid solutions. Gas in liquid, liquid in liquid, solid in liquid. Come to the third type, gas in solid, liquid in solid, and solid in solid. So I've just written examples, and we have the solute will always be lesser in amount and the larger amount would be for the solvent. So you have gas in gas, example is air mixture. Then you have liquid in gas, we say water vapors suspended in air. That can be an example. Solid in gas, if you take a camphor, a piece of camphor, and you keep it in atmosphere or you keep it in some gaseous mixture. So camphor in nitrogen gas will be solid in gas. Coming to the second type, gas in liquid. If I say gas in liquid, we can always talk of oxygen gas that is dissolved in water. So that is an example of gas in liquid. If I say liquid in liquid, so you can have two liquids mix, it can be, but we have to take such liquids which can evenly mix. So we have written ethanol in water. It cannot be kerosinol because they are immiscible, they will not mix uniformly. Then solid in liquid, we can always take sugar or salt, dissolve it in water. That would be an example of solid in liquid. Coming to gas in solid. You have hydrogen gas, we use it as a catalyst and we always pass the hydrogen gas over a surface. That surface is palladium or platinum. So that process is known as hydrogenation, if you remember. So that is an example of gas in solid. So hydrogen over palladium. liquid in solid. So liquid in solid, we have heard of amalgams. Amalgam is nothing but associated with mercury. So mercury is in liquid state. If you have any metal dissolved in mercury, we call it as amalgam. So we have written the example as sodium amalgam. Coming to the last type, that is solid in solid. So solid in solid, we call it as alloys. I've already talked about it, that alloys are nothing but a mixture of two metals in some proportion so that we change their properties and get a different set of properties. So alloys are mixture of solid in solid. So basically these all are type of solutions, but we will mainly focus here on liquid solutions. So liquid solutions, again, when we talk about, the main concentration is we have to find out how concentrated is the solution. So that concentration, what does it mean? You have to actually know how much solute is going in how much solution. So that we talk in terms of concentration of solutions. So basically we talk about all these ways in which we can calculate the concentration of solutions. So what are the ways? The first way would be calculating the percentage. The percentage can be calculated in three ways. It can be mass percentage, it can be volume percentage, it can be mass by volume percentage. If you calculate mass percentage, we say you calculate the mass of that component divided by the total mass of solution into 100, because it's percentage. Then we talk of volume percentage, we say volume of that component divided by the total volume of solution multiplied by 100, because again it's a percentage. When we say mass by volume percentage, it is mass of that component by volume of total solution into 100. It's just ways and means to describe how concentrated is your solution. You can either tell in terms of mass, you can either talk in term of volume, or you can talk in terms of either both of them. So these three are percentage: mass percentage, volume percentage, and mass by volume percentage. Then we talk